bit more TNT. Our next guests are most unique, to say the least. And one of the reasons why they're most unique is that the manager of the Rustler is more popular than the Rustler. Would you please welcome the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and his manager, Elizabeth.
Right now, see some wrestlers in a wrestling ring. Not the Macho Man Randy Savage. What's wrong, man? You guys are missing the boat. Pseudo athletes, every one of them. Get them out of the ring. I'll stand in there right now. Who's on the cover of the magazine? Not me. No, not me.
Why don't you have a seat?
I'm gonna have a seat before. Future world heavyweight champion is gonna sit in this chair right now. What? They know it, baby.
I gather you don't like Hulk, huh?
Hulk Hogan is gonna be history, and that's a promise. 1986 is the Macho Man Randy Savage's year.
Let me ask you, Mr. Savage, do you take offense to the fact that the vast majority of fans certainly, they applaud Elizabeth. Many of them boo you, but they applaud. It seems that Elizabeth is much more popular than you are. Do you take exception to that?
A lot of people are ignorant. Yes, they are. And a lot of people are jealous of success. When one man is such a greatest athlete in the world and nobody can perceive it, no. They sit there at home with their wives and they stare into the video scope and they see this guy who is outstanding, yeah, does things that he says he's gonna do and they get jealous. You understand that, Hayes?
Yes, but are you jealous? I think that was the question
five minutes ago.
Oh, no.
This lady right here, this woman right here, is the Macho Man Randy Savage's property. Nobody messes with the Macho Man Randy Savage's property. As minute as she is to Macho Madness, no one messes with my property. And let me point a finger right now. Let me point a finger at Lou Albano, yeah, and George Steele. Just let me point a finger, yeah. Why don't I just say that I'm pointing a finger at them? Captain Lou, captain of a garbage truck. Like to see Andre the Giant come into the ring with me, I'd slap him in the face.
We have some footage of you, and I'm sure you would want to enjoy watching yourself, so we have some footage we brought along. Yeah. The Macho Man in action.
Yeah, sue me.
Go to Florida, weighing 235 pounds, led by Elizabeth, here is Macho Man Randy Savage.
On his way to the ring, and behind the Macho, Elizabeth. I think we just lost Elizabeth. She's back there somewhere.
I enjoy this, McMahon, because Elizabeth knows her place.
Someone just handed Elizabeth a bouquet of flowers on her way to the ring. She is a lovely lady. So someone handing Elizabeth some flowers on her way to the ring, which I'm sure she greatly appreciates. She's quite a lady. The Macho Man preparing for his matchup. The Macho looks over to Elizabeth now.
Look at this.
He might be questioning where the flowers came from.
I think he definitely is.
I don't think he likes it.
I don't blame him. I mean, some stranger walking up and handing her flowers and she accepts it. I think Macho Man's totally in the right, McMahon.
This is, we apologize for the conduct of this man.
Why are you apologizing?
That is obviously no way to treat a lady.
Elizabeth's going to think twice next time before she takes flowers from some stranger in Japan.
I think she's crying. Goofy Macho Man. I must say, this is one time my bias is going to show. I am very, very hopeful that Gary Starr defeats the Macho Man.
Now, wait a minute, McMahon. You're supposed to be an unbiased announcer out here.
Not in this match. Not after what we just saw.
Look at that beautiful suplex by Randy Macho Man Savage. He's going up already, McMahon. Do you believe this? Whoa. Your wish is not going to come true, McMahon.
Ha-ha. Well, you have to give the Macho Man credit for his physical prowess, but his despicable display of conduct moments ago.
With Elizabeth, and again, we apologize. Look at this. Well, this guy's a creep.
Well, I'll tell you what.
This guy's a jerk.
That's right,
he's a jerk.
He's a jerk, Don. Don't you talk about my tag team partner that way.
Well, that's too bad he's your tag team partner. This guy's a creep and a jerk.
Unbelievable, man. Was that off the top of your head? Did you give that some thought?
Well, based upon that was an edited version of that match. based upon what we saw in the unedited version, in which you, well, what you were doing with the flowers and Elizabeth, obviously that's why we had to edit the match. It was unsportsmanlike, to say the least.
Yeah, well, let it be.
Elizabeth, how do you feel about
that? Wait a minute, I was going to say something right there.
But I want to ask Elizabeth.
Let it be a warning to everybody out there. Any present that you want to give Elizabeth, make sure it fits inside your body sideways, and there'll be no problem. Ask Elizabeth the question.
As in ingestion.
Either or, whatever. Don't matter to me, man. I am the superior athlete, aren't I, Elizabeth? I am 110% athlete. Can Hulk Hogan stop me in 1986? No way. Say it louder. Say no way.
There's no way.
No way, yeah.
All right, well, when we come back, if you don't mind, we would like to ask Elizabeth a couple of questions. Right now,
Big elbow, yeah!
We'll be back.
On anybody!
Elizabeth?
Yeah, okay, talk to me.
Hello,
one second,
Elizabeth.
And I'm gonna, listen.
We could just ask Elizabeth a few questions, if you don't mind.
Try starting with one question.
We'll try one.
We'll find out if we got that right kind of momentum. Yeah.
Elizabeth, what can you possibly see in the Macho Man?
Man, what a bad start.
I mean,
what a bad start. Try this and emphasize one time, huh? Kiss right there. Yeah. Now, this one right here. Give me a kiss on the arm right there. Now, sit down. Need we say any more? Hulk Hogan, man, I got dreams about you. Yeah.
I'll tell you what we're going to do right now.
Down to the floor with the big elbow. Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
We're going to take you to some footage that we saw just last Saturday night, and footage that probably is going to upset you. Let's roll the tape. Now, George the Animal Steel obviously is smitten with Elizabeth.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there seems to be, he seems to be quite fond of Elizabeth. Elizabeth, how do you feel about George the Animal Steel?
Well,
let me tell you something right now. Well, it's totally 1,000% wrong. Do you know that?
Wrong.
You know it.
She was sitting.
You're
was
my
sitting
property.
On the rope.
Nobody touches or messes with the Macho Man's property. I was talking to some stupid broad here in the audience who wanted to meet me outside, and I was telling her, no way, no way. Told her husband to sit down, and I was just about to slap him into the bleachers. Yeah. George Steele, you want a bottle?
But there obviously seems to be some sort of affection between George Steele and Elizabeth. Obviously, George Steele has feelings for Elizabeth. Elizabeth, how do you feel about George Steele? If you'd please allow her to answer the question.
I'm going to tell you something right now. You stop. You don't say nothing. In fact. In fact, yeah. You want a bottle. Let me tell you something about you want a bottle. Shut up, Dick.
All right.
Bat boy.
I think a good time for us to say goodbye. I think a good time for us to say goodbye. We'll be back with the Polish Power. Ivan Putski. Stay with us.